and I sort of almost got in hang of the transition. And as soon as I was about to kind of celebrate that transition, I heard a big clunk from underneath the car. And our instructor was like, oops, this is something which we are not used to hearing every day. So I've always been into kind of having fun with cars and bikes. I never sort of, you know, kind of enjoy driving cars or riding bikes in a very normal fashion. Even when I was more into motorcycles, I was always, you know, trying to have as much fun and excitement that I could extract out of motorcycles. And that sort of led me into, first of all, meeting some of the best enthusiasts in the country, as well as in our hometown of Pune. And we formed a club and we did everything from stunt riding to drag racing to every kind of shenanigans that was possible. Thankfully, back then the traffic was not as bad as it is today. So there was a lot more margin of error, and thankfully I would say that we survived. And eventually grew into motorcycles, and then eventually as time progressed, grew out of motorcycles as well, and sort of started getting interested in cars. But that passion, or that, you know, joy of doing something different, of either driving differently or riding differently, stunt riding, mischievousness basically around motoring, mischievousness around cars and bikes always stayed with us. And I sort of wanted to transition into a space which was very less explored in India, but at the same time, since now, you know, we've been exposed to digital content from all across the world, we all know, you know, what all is happening in the international scene. Plus, when I was working with Evo, I had an opportunity to meet with Mr. Gautam Singhania as well. And he was one of the first people in this country who sort of was at that level of enthusiasm where he had his own circuit in Thane, and he had basically constructed the whole circuit so that he could introduce, first of all, himself as well as the rest of the country, at least the petrol heads, to the concept of drifting. And that is actually the first time when I came across drifting live in front of my eyes. I mean, of course, we've seen it on YouTube, we've seen it on a lot of digital platforms, but that was the first time when I actually experienced drifting in front of my eyes. And that sort of, you know, got me going that this is something I really want to do, since I have already previously associated myself with a lot of stunt riding, a lot of drag racing, and a lot of other, you know, performance-based enthusiast activities on motorcycles. I sort of thought it would be a great transition if I could, you know, move on to cars and sort of understand how to learn car control through the method of drifting. So initially, I thought that the best thing would be if you have your own car, you always have that opportunity of, you know, practicing and learning at your own pace. You have that opportunity of doing things whenever and however you want. And that is the reason why I think in 2014 is when I picked up a Mazda Miata, because I thought the short wheelbase and a relatively cheap car, which is rear wheel drive, would be a good fun car to drive, first of all. And at the same time, it will be a good car to, you know, learn drifting on as well. I had seen a lot of people abroad as well who used the Miata as their base to start off with when they started learning how to drift. And then they eventually moved on to, you know, like the LS swaps and locked and unlocked differentials at the back, so that, you know, they can get better and get more professional with drifting. So the first 3 or 4 months was actually quite tough, where we were actually trying to figure out a spot where we could practice. So eventually I had to give the car away. Thankfully, the car went to a really nice guy who's in Chennai, and he built the car up even more, and now that car has been turboed to about 250 horsepower. And the gentleman who owns the car now, he drives it religiously on the track. And then I was sort of thinking for a couple of years, what would be the next best option? How could, you know, I could take this a step further? And that's when I sort of started researching, and I found this place in Dubai called the Pro Drift Academy. So these guys are basically people who started off in the UK, and they've then branched out to places like Dubai. I think they're also in Thailand and a couple of other countries where they have a proper drifting school. So I was like, sure, this sounds like a great idea. And I tried booking myself a flight and a course with them at the soonest. Yeah, so I head out to Dubai in 2019, and we started off with the course. And it was, those guys were really professional in the way they, you know, address you as a customer. They start off by introducing you to their entire track. They start off by introducing you to their cars, the kind of setup they have, which is all very professional. And then, yeah, so first day was mostly theoretical, where they give you a little bit of briefing and introduction about what and how you're supposed to drift, what involves car control, and what are the right techniques. And they also give you an overview of the track. And second day is when we actually started getting onto the cars and starting drifting. So the first car that we started off with was a Nissan 350Z. And immediately after like a couple of runs, I sort of got a quick hang and a good hang of how to start off doing donuts, how to start doing long single-sided corners, single-sided drifts where we are not transitioning over to the other side. And then it was time to move on to the second stage, which was doing transitions, going, you know, coming into a corner and then transitioning in the middle of the corner, taking the corner on the other side and sort of doing like an S-bend with while completely going sideways. And that's where actually the trouble started happening. Because as you could imagine, when you're drifting on one side, things are quite simple because you're not going through that whole transition of understanding how to change the entire weight of the car, how to change the direction and how to still keep the drift going. So it took a lot of practice. It probably took about the first half of the day completely went in just learning how to transition, kept on spinning out here and there again and again and again. And as you'd imagine, Dubai is also not a very cold place. So the cars were heating up as well quite a lot. And then we went out and we kept on doing it again and again till the time we sort of got it right. And somewhere around the first end of the first half is when I sort of tried and I sort of almost got a hang of the transition. And as soon as I was about to kind of celebrate the transition, I heard a big clunk from underneath the car. And our instructor was like, oops, this is something which we are not used to hearing every day. Like, let's go out and let's check what's wrong with the car. So we look under the car and the entire prop shaft is sheared off. The prop shaft was literally hanging on the side. And that was kind of game over for the first car. So post lunch, we moved on to car number two. Car number two was a Infiniti G35. And we started using that as our second drift car. Didn't last for a very long time because in the next 2 hours, even that car gave up. That car gave up because the entire exhaust fell off the car while we were drifting. Not technically my fault, but I think the exhaust was mounted loose or something, and the exhaust just fell off the car, and we had to sort of kind of unfortunately call it a day. That was the end of day two. And thankfully, I had one more day with them, so I had some time. So whatever time we had sort of lost in transitioning from car number one to car number two, we could sort of make up on day three and, you know, continue with the training and hopefully complete the entire training. So I was training till level five. So they have, at Pro Drift Academy, they've got 6 levels in total, where level 1 is your basic drifting skills, level 2 is slightly more advanced, level 3 is where they start teaching you transitioning, level 4 and 5 is where they introduce you, level 4 is where they introduce you to the rest of the track, and level 5 is where you have to carry a continuous drift throughout their entire course. And then level 6 is something where they would actually take you out with more pro drifters, and they would sort of train you that if you're ever going to participate in any sort of a drift challenge, that is where they will sort of kind of give you that training where you're drifting in tandem with other people, you know, to get you sort of comfortable with that competitive environment. So my aim was to go to level 5, level 6 was not what I was aiming for, because I wanted to learn drifting for my personal joy and for, you know, understanding how car control works rather than going competitive. So day 3 we again got back to the track early morning. We wanted to start off as soon as possible because early morning Dubai is a relatively cold environment where cars don't take so much of the beating. They run at comparatively lower temperatures. The day started going well. We started level 4 where I was kind of understanding the entire track. I was drifting in parts throughout the entire circuit and I was getting a hang of all the different corners, the transitions and everything. And somewhere between level 4 and level 5 where you transition from going across the track in bits to understanding the entire track and taking the entire track in one full go, that's where we had another problem. I guess it was because of the heat and obviously because of the excessive brutality that the tires were facing. We had a puncture and that's how we lost our third car as well. Thankfully, the car that I broke on day 2, the first half of day 2, was repaired by then. So we had a spare car. So this car went in to get its puncture repaired, and the car previously that I had broken the drive shafts on had to be brought back in, thankfully repaired, to help us out with the final stage, you know, the level 5 of the circuit. Thankfully, that car lasted us the entire day and we were able to complete level 5 on that car. But that sort of gave me a good understanding working with three different cars, drifting with three different cars where they had all different wheelbases, they had all different, complete different setups. And yeah, I mean, I did break all their three cars, but I did learn drifting in a very nice and controlled environment. And I think that was one of the most exciting 3-day crash courses I've done for anything else in my life.